Hello and welcome to the DegreeWorks Planner Tips and Tricks tutorial. All students are now able to create their own term-by-term course plans using the Plans feature. You'll need to review these plans with your advisor. These plans should not replace academic advising. Graduating students are required to have a graduation course plan for the degree coordinator to evaluate their registered and planned courses. Due to the volume of applications, it can be 5 to 6 weeks to go through each application and review each graduation course plan. Be proactive and don't wait to be alerted of incorrect or missing information. Work with your advisor to ensure that your course plan meets all missing requirements for your degree. Keep in mind it is the student's responsibility to use DegreeWorks and to consult with their advisors to finish their degree requirements and resolve any items indicated as still needed in DegreeWorks. Still needed items are indicated in DegreeWorks by a red box and a requirement. In order to access DegreeWorks, you're going to want to log into your Inside SOU, and you'll find the link to DegreeWorks for Students under Online Services. So you'll click the DegreeWorks for Students there, and then to get started, we're going to click Plans, and it should appear under your name. If you haven't created a plan before, you'll see a dialog box that looks similar to this, and we can start with a blank plan. If you have already created a plan, you'll see your currently active plan in the window. Once you create a new plan, you can add a description, and for graduating students, you're going to call this graduation plan. This field cannot be blank before you continue. You have to type a name. Once you've typed the name, click on the active box to set this as your active plan. None of the other information in this upper portion should need to be modified. Once you've described the plan as your graduation plan and set it as active, you'll click the Save button down here in the lower right. Your plan is now saved. The boxes up at the top right of the plan box here, one is to add a term, one is to remove a term, and one is to add a notes section for the plan itself. But first, we're going to add a term. We're going to go ahead and add a term. The terms in this box are future terms that you can plan for. The currently in progress term isn't available to plan for because it's assumed that you're already in classes and in that term. So we are going to go ahead and schedule for a summer term. And you'll see that the summer 2020 term appears below. You can add more than one term as well. We can also add fall 2020 and winter 2021. Now you can see all of these terms appear in your plan. When you look to the right, you will see a still needed area. When you click this, it will show you all of the requirements that are currently unmet in your degree. For this student, Rosie Rader, she needs a course in Music 331, 335, 336, and a few others down the road. In order to plan for a course that you have an open requirement for, simply grab the course out of the right-hand box and drag it to the term in which you're planning on taking the course. You'll see that it populates in that term. You'll see it populates in that term with the course and the credits that the course is offered for. None of the other information should need to be modified. You can do this with any course that you have listed in your still needed. Simply drag the course to the term in which you want to complete it. Once you've planned a few courses and you want to refresh and see what is still left, even after your plan, you can click the Refresh button. The plan will refresh, and you'll be able to see that you don't need quite as many courses in the next term. There are two other ways of adding coursework to your plan. We can add a requirement here in the top right of a term, and we can click Course. This adds a blank line. Here you can type in what you need for the student music 400. Make sure there's a space between the subject and the number. And when you tab over, it will auto-populate the credits. If you are entering a variable credit course, it will populate with the maximum number of credits you can take that course for. You'll need to edit the course credits to the number of credits that you're planning on taking. Another way to add courses is you can click on the Courses section over here on the right, and you can search through and find the courses that you're looking for. Once you find a course that you need, you can grab it from the list and drag it to a term. There are other options in the Add a Requirement section, which is a non-course requirement. In this case, the student would need a piano proficiency test. And that's listed here under Piano Proficiency Exam. The other option is a comment or a placeholder. So you can add a placeholder and you can click comment and add a comment. You can enter other placeholder types, such as incomplete grade resolution and transcript from another institution, if those apply to you. If you're taking courses from another institution and planning to transfer them to SOU, you'll want to notify our degree coordinator via this transcript from another institution comment. If you have incomplete grades on your record, a degree cannot be awarded with incomplete grades, and you'll need to have a plan to resolve those. So you'll let the graduation coordinator know that through the incomplete grade resolution comment. The value column here only has a character limit of 50 characters, so you're going to want to be very brief when you put something in there. You can, however, use the notes function on the right-hand side. Just by clicking this little notepad thingy, you can add a note by clicking Add Note. And these notes are freeform and have no character limit, so you can type whatever you want. Once you're done, click Done. And you can see that the note is filled out, and if you hover over it, you can see the actual note itself. Notes can be added to requirements, they can be added to courses, they can be added to terms, and they can be added to the plan overall. Anywhere that you need to let the degree coordinator know, you can leave a note. These will show up later when we do an audit. Once you're happy with your plan, and you've put in all of the courses that you plan to take for the next few terms, or for any term between now and graduation, you can click the Save button, and then we can see it in the DegreeWorks audit by clicking the Audit button. If you scroll down, you can see that anything that you put in your plans will show up in blue and be listed as a planned course. So Music 400 Capstone is planned for 2 credits in summer. So all of your planned courses will show in blue on the DegreeWorks audit. If they do meet the requirement will show as in progress with the small blue tilde in the box. For a graduation plan, you will want to make sure all of your courses that you have in your plan satisfy all of the requirements for your degree. You can take a look at the audit while you're planning and see your plan at the same time if you click the View dropdown and click Audit. This will show you your planned courses on the right-hand side, and it will show you your audit on the left-hand side. Now, you can't edit your plan from this view. You will have to go back to the View option and select Edit to be able to edit your plan. Once you've finished, make sure that you've saved your plan. You can tell that you've saved it by looking down here at the Save button, and if it's grayed out, you've saved your plan. If you need to make changes and you want to keep your original plan, you can make your changes that you wish, and then type in a new description, and then click Save As. This will save the plan as a new plan, and it will set it as the active plan. Once you've finished your plan and your audit shows that all of the courses are in progress or planned, you're done. The degree coordinator will evaluate your application and let you know of anything that needs to be done. A final note, if you're pursuing more than one degree, or if you're pursuing a certificate and a degree, you'll need to enter graduation plans for each individually. Other degree types will show up under the degree type here. You'll be able to see either another bachelor's degree or another certificate. So make sure that you're doing your graduation plans for both degrees. If you have any questions, you can email graduation@sou.edu, and our graduation coordinator will be happy to help you. Thanks, and have a great day.